Welcome to today's video on the hyperinflation crisis that plagued the Weimar Republic or Germany after World War I. The Weimar Republic was the name taken by Germany during 1918 until 1933, after World War I, where Germany lost to the Allies. The period was known for the hyperinflation crisis as well as the political extremism, which in turn gave rise to Hitler and the Nazi. In this video, we'll be exploring the conditions that led to the economic crisis, the chain of events that followed, and the devastating effects of hyperinflation. At the same time, we will explain some of the economic mechanics that took place. To understand the hyperinflation crisis, we first need to look at the conditions that Germany faced after World War I. At the end of the war, the Treaty of Versailles, signed in 1919, imposed a heavy reparations on Germany. Germany lost 12% of its territory, 10% of its population, 43% of its pig iron capacity, and 38% of its steel capacity. The German mark lost 90% of its value between 1919 and 1920, and inflation soared as high as 200% over the period. But the devaluation of the mark led to a strong export, as the German goods becomes cheap. The economy stabilized by the early 1921. The final trigger to the hyperinflation came with the London Ultimatum in May 1921. Designed perhaps to cripple Germany, this was a new reparation treaty imposed by the Allies. It demands 132 billion marks, or about 330% of Germany's GDP at the time. The reparation mechanic was simply impossible for Germany, as it fell behind on its payments. France, with deep resentments with Germany, took the opportunity to occupy the Ruhr Valley, a major industrial region in Germany. This was made in order to confiscate the industrial output of the region. This led to strikes, protests, and even violence by the German people. The German government did not act when workers stopped all production and resist the occupation. To compensate, the government simply printed money to support the workers and pay off its debt and obligations. Printing too much money eventually led to the devaluation of the German currency and a rise in prices. Currency is a mean of exchange. In the modern economy, a currency is a backed up by something valuable like gold or some international foreign reserves, b backed up by the trust of a country or what is known as the fiat currency system, like the Fed in the USA, where the Fed prints the money, backed by the trust of being the world reserve currency. Most countries today rely on the fiat system, but also has a healthy level of foreign reserves to build confidence in the currency. In the case of the Weimar Republic, it originally had some gold reserves. But eventually, printing too much money compared to the gold in reserves quickly led to hyperinflation. The economic crisis deepened as the German government continued to print more money to pay off its debts and fund its programs. This led to hyperinflation. The value of the German mark plummeted, and prices for goods and services soared. The hyperinflation crisis reached its peak in November 1923, when prices doubled every 2 days. People were paid twice a day, and businesses would change their prices multiple times a day just to keep up with the inflation. Generally, if a country does not increase any economic output, printing money will simply drive up the prices of all goods and services. This is purely logical, as the prices is simply the sum of money divided by the total output. If there are more money chasing over the same goods, prices will rise. The effects of hyperinflation were devastating for the German people. Their life savings were wiped out, and their purchasing power diminished to almost nothing. People would use wheelbarrows full of money to buy a loaf of bread, and workers were paid in bundles of cash rather than receiving a steady wage. The middle class was hit the hardest, as their savings and investments became worthless overnight. Businesses closed down, and unemployment rose sharply. In a hyperinflation, there is no incentive to keep any cash, because its value quickly diminishes. People will, as quickly as possible, convert them to any physical goods. A pair of shoes remains exactly the same pair of shoes in a week. But a million mark could buy a pair of shoes today and barely buys anything in a week. As millions of German marks were being printed every day, quickly, people lost trust, and they became just paper. By 1924, the Allies recognized the potential damages to everybody. The consequence of an economic collapse in Germany does more harm than good to the Allies. The Allies then agreed to reduce the reparation debt and extend the existing payments. At the same time, the new Central Bank of Germany issued new money with a fixed exchange to the US dollar and a very strict printing policy. Through a lot of pain, the economy began to stabilize. In conclusion, the hyperinflation crisis in Germany after World War I was the result of a combination of factors, including the heavy reparations imposed by the Treaty of Versailles, the occupation of the Ruhr Valley, and the government's decision to print more money to fund its programs. The experience of hyperinflation in Germany serves as a cautionary tale about the dangers of unchecked money printing and the importance of sound monetary policy. Thank you for watching, and we hope you found this video informative.